This is episode 29 of Blue Hose Break, featuring new head women's basketball coach, Tiffany Sardin. This episode of Blue Hose Break is brought to you by Self Regional Healthcare.
Been fortunate to grow up around basketball. It's kind of started with my brothers playing in the alleyway, just hoping to get picked up, and started from there. Like, my love and passion for it took off at a very young age. Played co-ed with the boys, doing a little bit of AAU season starting out, and then finally was able to just play with the all females team. But it's been, obviously, it's led me to where I'm at right now. I've always loved it. I continue to love it, and just, you know, happy to be a part of the game, and it's growing. Playing overseas was quite the experience. It was a great experience, honestly. I tell our women or any player, former player of mine that's considering or thinking about playing, to go and explore that opportunity. You know, not many people get a chance to go and live in a different country, experience a different culture. So it's a really cool experience. I play for a really awesome coach who I still have a really great relationship with now. And crazy enough, I actually have a few former players that play for the coach that I played for in my career overseas. But great experience. Wouldn't change it for anything. Waking up, living on the water, waking and seeing all that beautiful blue water was just really special, and it's just refreshing, but super great experience, and would encourage anybody to go for it. And my college experience, played at University of Virginia, played for Coach Debbie Ryan, and had a lot of really great assistant coaches, great relationship to this day. Played ACC. The ACC obviously looks very different now than what it was when I was in school, but great experience. Was fortunate to be a three-year captain, only the second player in school history to be named that, and just awesome experience, and still talk to a lot of my teammates who I play with during that time, and just, wouldn't trade that either. I would say it's probably a handful of my teammates that are in coaching right now. We never imagined that we would be coaches. Just, you know, back then being players, you thinking like, oh, you're gonna play forever, or, you know, do something else besides coach, because we knew how much we drove our coaches crazy during our time. But the relationship that I have with my old teammates and former players from my school, it's just wonderful, right? Because those are connections that has lasted a lifetime, and still able to pick up the phone and just pick things off their brain and just, you know, just talk about life. You know, I have teammates, I've been to their weddings and been to their kids' birthday parties and just been a part of a lot of life things just going on. But those connections, again, as we share with our women, they'll last for a lifetime, and that's what you really want to take out of a college experience. It's the relationship piece, and the sisterhood is special. There was a social major, went into college, just being really honest, went into college thinking, oh, I'm gonna be a physical therapist and all that, and, you know, got into some classes that just weren't quite for me at the time, so, you know, had to change it up. But social, I just love people. You know, I love the relationship piece of getting to know people, understanding communities, areas, all those special things that, you know, help and grow, build relationships. But I was a social major, and that was my major. I enjoyed it, and again, thought I was going to do something different, but me and sciences and different things in the physical therapy, it just didn't line up. I had some really cool stops. Even before Mount Olive, I had a little stint of coaching high school basketball, and I did some varsity. Athletic director Crystal Worley, who I still talk to this day, a huge supporter and just a mentor of mine, but gave me an opportunity to figure out if this is something that I wanted to do, and I was still actually playing professional overseas, so had a little stop because I dealt with an injury, and she took a chance on me, and it kind of gave me that confidence that I think I might want to do this. I really do. And after that, playing a few more seasons after coaching high school, and went on and had the opportunity to coach at Mount Olive. Was only there for one season for Coach Wendy Lee, another coach who took a really huge chance on me, just giving me the opportunity to get my feet wet in the college, at the college level, and great experience. We won the conference in my first year there and had built awesome relationships with the women that I were coaching and still talk to these same women to this day. And from there, had the opportunity to go back home and coach under someone who actually recruited me going up through the high school, Regina Miller over at UIC. And from UIC, spent two seasons there. We actually won the WBI championship. We had the biggest turnaround, I believe, in our second year there, which was awesome. It was exciting to be back home because at that point I hadn't been back home in probably 10 years. So I was able to go back home and be in a space that was familiar to me because we actually used to have our city championship games played in that arena. So to be able to play and coach in that arena was really special. After there, had stops at Boston University, Clemson up the road, and then went to Longwood, then back home to Chicago State, and went from Chicago State to St. Louis. And like I said, a season ago, had an awesome year at St. Louis, got to kind of reconnect with Coach Tillett, who I work with at Longwood, and help, you know, build a great program. And after I left there, you saw what Longwood was able to do in her fourth year there, win the Big South tournament and go on to play in the championship. But it was really special, and those relationships obviously lasted and continue to last. And after I left Chicago State, I ended up at St. Louis, reunited with Coach Tillett and some of those former players that I was a part of recruiting and helping bring to Longwood. And just really special. We were able to win the conference and make it to the NCAA tournament again, another first in program history. So just a lot of really cool, special moments that I'm super grateful for that has really prepared me again for this opportunity. It's a conference, obviously, Coach Sharp, I continue to watch and follow the Big South, you know, and Coach Sharp, we've actually kind of communicated a little bit over time and just kind of some of those congratulation texts over the past few years, or heck, I think I was recruiting a player from here who was coming out of here. She was a graduate. So we were still kind of touching base, but I was always following the Big South program, and just to be back here in South Carolina, the South and South Carolina has always felt special to me, even with my time at Clemson, working with my former assistant coach from college. But it's always been a special place to me. I love the weather. I thought the people here were great. And, you know, PC, coming off a heck of a year that you all are coming off of, like, who wouldn't want to be a part of something like that? Who wouldn't want to keep, you know, things, special things going and just helping continue to create magic and, you know, hopefully repeat. That's the plan for sure. Never really been above any task, right? Like, yeah, you move over a seat, you go from giving suggestions to really making decisions and things like that. But again, just remaining the same true person, genuine person who I am, regardless of the title. Learned a lot again, like even going from head coach to back to associate head coach, it's still things that, you know, help prepare me for each step and each change and the opportunities that I've had. So, I mean, it's just been special, and it's just nothing but growth. You know, I'm someone who loves to continue to learn and grow along with those people beside me. So, yeah. I absolutely think it will help. Obviously, it's changed and it's grown, and some teams have left. From when it was when I was at Longwood, but again, every place I've been has really prepared me for another opportunity. I'm used to the small town feel and things like that, but you know, Longwood, it truthfully really prepared me for PC. You know, just a small town, kind of a lot of similarities in the size of the school. But it's also a conference who's hungry to continue with success, not just in women's basketball, but all their sports. And I love the fact that, you know, I've always said Big South was a basketball conference, and hopefully that doesn't mess with anybody, but we've always felt like it was a true basketball conference, and it's a special conference where, you know, your teams and players can experience team success, but also individuals as well. I hope I'm not leaving anybody out, but I possibly can. So my high school coach, like, she was amazing. I would say she certainly has prepared me. She prepared me for college and just, you know, what does it look like to be a coach, right? A coach who, you know, genuinely cares about her players and all those special things that, you know, I try to show as I grow, continue to grow as a coach. But I would say my coach, Dorothy Gators from high school, had Coach Tillett, I've learned a lot under her, Coach Audra Smith, just, you know, so many people that I've just been fortunate to really be under their leadership and be led by that. You know, I aspire to be them, but also continue to grow myself as a coach. Certainly picked up a lot along the way of, you know, just how to treat people. That's the most important thing, how they treated us as players and just people, period. But just, you know, how to run the organization, how to just do things. I've always, like, just was in awe of how they, you know, handle so many things that's thrown at you that you can never really be prepared for unless you go through it. But just some of those things that, you know, I've been able to watch them do and how they handle it, and just like, okay, I'm gonna take that with me. That, yep, I got that. That's awesome. And, you know, just to be able to pick up the phone and call them too whenever I need something or have a question about something, just really hearing their advice and feedback on things as well. Everything is happening there, like I was sharing with you all. But it's a good space to be in, honestly. It's exciting for me to just being able to recruit young women here and continue to recruit the young women that are returning and just really building relationships. And, you know, right now, currently just doing a lot of different things. It's like prioritizing at this moment, but just, you know, I'm still super excited and just knocking one task off at a time, honestly. But the excitement of just recruiting people and building the staff all over again, and just happy to bring all the folks around for you all to meet, so yeah. Character, like how they are as people, right? Like just how they genuinely are as people, you know, what's their work ethic like. I love hardworking people to be alongside me. But just, you know, their skill set and, you know, how they'll fit into what it is that we're trying to do as a program, right? Like there's some super talented kids out there, but sometimes fit just doesn't always match with the character. So, you know, I do look at the character for sure and how they are as people, and then kind of go from there. You certainly gonna see somebody who is passionate, who really care a great amount about the game of basketball, who respect the game at a really high level. But you're gonna see that in the young women. You're gonna see a bunch of hardworking young women on the court, just playing an exciting brand of basketball, getting after it, fighting every possession, every opportunity, all the way to the very last buzzer that you hear on the floor. But someone who's just committed and wants to win. And Chicago, that's home for me. It's just so much stuff you can do in Chicago. You know, if you want to get on the lake, get on the boat, you can do that. I hear you can do that here as well. Actually, I've experienced that here. But if you want to just, you know, just, I'm a big family person, so I spend a lot of time with my nieces and nephew. They're coming up. They're sports people as well. So that's been exciting. But just a huge family person. And I tend to like host a lot of family gatherings, so that'll change a little bit. But really, you know, when I'm in Chicago, I probably spend a lot of time with my family, or just going to a sporting event. Like I shared, my nieces and nephews, nephew in particular, they're big sports people, basketball and football, and it's just fun to watch them and just sit in the stands from a different perspective. It's hard because you like, I want to coach them on that and just give them a little feedback afterwards. What I choose to do and just kind of sit there and cheer, how I like parents to do for us. I'm so plain, like. I love rice, all types of rice, like just no spicy food. I'm not a spicy eater at all. So I do love like fish and chicken. Sometimes I kind of go into this thing where a few of my players will tell you, I say I'm a vegan. Like sometimes I want to eat meat and sometimes I just want to just be vegan or whatever. So I like to mix it up. Love ice cream. I'm a big ice cream person. So homemade ice cream in particular, but yeah, the food, just pretty plain. Really, rice is my favorite. I can eat it with anything and probably every day. The past year or so, I've been fortunate. The winter in Chicago has been mild. So when I say mild, that means like not a lot of snow, if barely any. But yeah, definitely excited not to see really snow. And if I do see it, it's like just covering the bottom of my shoe and like how adjusting again to how everything's shut down. But No, I'm excited about the weather, like the nature, being able to get out and just enjoy nature. I like the hike as well, so, and I do like the golf too, so, but yeah. Good question. So far I've been to lacrosse game. I went to the pasture. Me and a couple of the returners, we went and had dinner or lunch at the pasture on a Sunday. So got to experience that food. It was really good. Limited menu options, but the food was really good and the host was super kind to us. So we all talked about like, yeah, this is a place we would definitely come back to. So, but I'm excited to explore a lot of different things. I finally made my way down to Lawrence, I think it is, over there by the Walmart and everything like that. So I'm definitely looking forward to exploring more things because I want to get out to the lake and, you know, I'm get lost here. It's what, you know, I plan to do. Everybody been so great, right? Really, walking on campus, it just started off with me going to the Vista Bowl in the morning and just, you know, people kind of looking like, are you the new coach or whatever? Like, certainly make you feel special, and I appreciate that. But men's basketball, Coach Q and his staff, Coach Griff, they've been awesome, really awesome to me. Everybody, Jesse yourself, have been super awesome. And then, you know, I was fortunate to go over and kind of sit down with the baseball coach, Coach Eldon, and really just, you know, hear his vision and just, you know, how he's been doing it, right? Like, he's been here a really long time, former player here, all those cool things, but that's just something to say, you know, about this place and, you know, how special it is because he's an alum, but he's, you know, he's been here and he's seen so much change and just kind of getting his insight on some things and just knowing that, you know, he's available. He wants to help me in any way he can, so I really appreciate that, but you know, I would say all the coaches have been super awesome in the administration and just faculty walking on campus, walking through. I mean, it's been wonderful. So I wish that will continue to go, like, you know, keep going. And I'm excited to just get to know more people, honestly. I think fans should know that, you know, they're welcome to come into our space anytime. Like, I want to meet people. I enjoy meeting people. I'm super approachable. Like, you know, I know sometimes we might think that the basketball kind of make us be a little intense, but you know what? I enjoy meeting people and I want people to come out and support us, you know, and stick with us through it all.